Starting work on a project called Shhout, and it's for a company called Core Creative. Starting from drawings and visualizations, we see the breakdown of the box as the client would like it to come apart. So taking their drawings and their concepts, we actually start to work out how we're going to construct the whole unit. It was very important for the client that the box came apart in several pieces, and it was also very light, so we've decided to build it from fiberglass. We're adding the actual core of the orange into the fiberglass gel coat, so the actual basic colour when it comes out from the box that you see us laying up here is an orange, and then we add the graphics afterwards. Once we know the overall size of the Shhout box, we have some graphics drawn up and we have some vinyl cut, which is going to be done in black. And here you can see us actually colouring in the areas which we know is going to be cut out from the box and then recessed back, because it's nice to give it some kind of three-dimensional feel to the whole box. Here we are cutting out the letters from the paper, and then we're going to transfer the paper letters onto a hardboard with a shiny surface. And once we've got this, which is about a 5mm thickness, and then we sand all the edges down and make sure it's ready for the job. Once all the letters are made, cut and cleaned up, we put them face down onto the actual shiny wood, and we make sure they're up in reverse order, because we're taking a mould from these, so everything will come out in a kind of mirrored image way. Once we're happy with all the graphics and the wood is actually smart and clean and presented in exactly the way the client wants, we then proceed with the cleaning up, and we add 3 coats of wax to this, and this is mainly to make sure it pops out of the mould as cleanly as possible, as we do not want to create any kind of defects within the surface of the gel coat. And also along the side of the 5mm wood we add a chamfer, and this also aids us to get it out as if it's a kind of pyramid just falling out of the mould. Now, the client was quite clear that whoever was going to be taking this box out of the bag and reassembling it and taking it down again, it was as simple as possible. So we actually added some hinges to the edge of the box, and we thought this was a great idea until we actually put it into motion, and in reality it created a sort of stress along the hinges themselves and stress along the actual side of the fiberglass, which we didn't like. Now, although it opened and closed quite well, there was a little bit of play within the hinge, which we didn't like as well, and also there was a pulling motion on the front surface of the fiberglass. Once again, we took off the hinges and we added blocks to them to see if it would happen a little more clean, a little more neater. But we found that there was other complications, and it was actually putting stress on the fiberglass at the front edges. So we scrapped this idea of putting hinges in, so we're grinding them out here. We actually sorted out the hinge problem with magnets. We put magnets on the front side and the edges, so all you do is offer the two up and they snap together, so nice and simple. Also, the top came together in 2 halves, which butterfly clipped together, and this was nice and simple as well, so 2 people putting this box up just lifts the cap on and it keeps it all nice and smart. Here we are just taking it apart now, and I'm pulling off the edges from the magnets, so no clips, no screws or bolts, it just snaps together nice and clean, nice and effective. Now, according to the graphics, on one edge of the box it actually had a big tick which went on the top. We wasn't sure how to build this, do we build it in wood, polystyrene, but we wanted to make sure it had the same graphics and the pigment colour as the rest of the box, so we actually built it in fiberglass and then clad it. There's all sorts of inherent problems with creating something which is extremely light and extremely strong and flexible at the same time. So we found that we had to add some aluminium angle line in the back of it just to keep the front surfaces flat. Once we're happy with all the build of the box, we get on with the cleaning up, and this takes it's a bit of a long, laborious process, and we're cleaning up and mopping the front side of the gel coat. It really is strange, because you think you've actually got it quite neat and quite clean, but every time you put it in a different light or come back the very next day, you see something else. So it feels like a never-ending process. Here we are now, just trying to add some graphics or vinyl lettering to the front surface of the gel coat. We failed miserably three times until we went on the internet and we discovered how to apply the vinyl a lot more successfully. So it worked out well in the end. Now here at Sculpture Studios, we are used to building something of any size, any description. But this particular project kind of manifested into a kind of graphic base or even a sign writers type project. And it's particularly difficult to keep things really, really clean and sharp in our environment. But I think we managed it all the same, and it's turned out really lovely. Now, when all the box is finished, it's been polished, the graphics has been applied, I invite the client down to see it, and he has a look around the whole thing, and he might see little indiscretions, like a little scratch here and there, or the tape peeling off somewhere. So we try and correct them before he comes and picks it up next time. I think if I was to approach a project like this next time, we would build something first to make sure we know how it all goes together and what process we're going to proceed with, and then we would go through all our learning curve and R&D development, and then get on and make the master the second time. We have a leg that tucks up and then lifts down into position, and it just holds the lid up in situ. The whole project was for comedians to go around to schools and certain venues and talk to children and about sex and sexually transmitted diseases in a very friendly way. And this is just as an object to have around them and keep getting the word shh and then out, as if it's quiet but now out in the open. And I think it works very, very well. Now wait a minute.